Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Street Fighter Duel on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. We will be able to easily download and install Street Fighter Duel and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Street Fighter Duel. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else mates, to start we need to launch our favorite browser. We selected the one we prefer. Let's continue, going to this URL I have highlighted in green color. There you are seeing it on the screen of the PC. You don't need to type it, simply because I provided the link in the description of this video and the first pinned comment. We arrived right here on our own internet site of Usitility, at which we have a nice precise explanation on the way to download Street Fighter Duel on laptop or computer. We browse down a tad and just click on the Download Game on PC button. After we click on that link, we reach the site of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we are going to run to get access to that game Street Fighter Duel on PC. As you can discover here, we get a great deal of advantages of preferring using that emulator. Then, we are on the way to proceed to download the Street Fighter Duel by simply clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green color. Next step is clicking on that button. Of course, the download action takes no time at all. Voila, here is located the download. It is an executable file. The following step is to run the executable file, so we have to click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to make modifications to the laptop or device. We answered yes. I reduced the web browser to view the installation software considerably better. The installation software is pretty simple. It contains a couple of choices, install, and setup path. I will describe what setup path really does. We purely click on it. And now we observe that they got here the path in which the emulator can be placed. If we would like to vary this directory, we have to click on the browse option, and therefore we opt for another directory and set up the emulator specifically where we want. To keep it simple, just leave it as it is. I simply click back, and therefore I pick install. Great. The install starts and it is going to go forward along with the download of all these MB that happens to be represented on this screen. After you download it, it is likely to be more or less megabytes. The data transfer rate can be faster or at a lower speed, depending on your type of connection and depending on the speed capacity of the emulator hosting servers. Right away they're progressing very fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this point, the emulator has actually been launched successfully. As you will notice, down here, we have a progress bar which will move forward to the right when it has reached the finish, the emulator is going to be started for the first time. Believe it or not, the emulator was already started, there for the first time. Before we continue on, as you can see now, it has made a couple of software icons there on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon will be the one we are concerned with. Each time we need to operate Street Fighter Duel on the laptop or computer, we double-click this software icon and as a result run the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. We should perform the next phase, which is actually a must-have, and this is to visit the Google Play Store. And we'll simply click on Play Store. As can be seen, the Google Play is presented. There we are required to log on. Right now, as soon as we're on this page, we have to begin doing the following step, which is imperative. So that we simply click on Sign In. At this point it announces Checking Info. It may once in a while get blocked in checking info, that's why it fails to continue. In that case, you could attempt to connect to your account after a number of hours, but it will surely quite likely be repaired. At this point we will type our email and password. The email address needs to be a Gmail email address and its matching password. For example, you can utilize the very same email you're using at this time in your own YouTube account. Then I am going to provide my data and I'll return immediately after I have accomplished it. That's all, details typed in. Find out Google welcoming us and presenting us their twos. We will approve them by just pressing, I agree. After that, it allows us to backup to the Google Cloud. You might keep it selected, it's going to build a backup of your data on that device to Google Drive. I will not check it. You can utilize this option if you like. We simply click on accept. The Google Play Store is launched without need to open it manually and immediately. To set up the video game, we would need to browse the Android emulator desktop by clicking that icon designated green colored. Today that we are watching the desktop of that Android emulator, we can see that we come with right here the install video game option. We click on that button. Right here we get the game app. Let's simply click right here on the install link that I am showing now in green. Therefore it will begin the software installation. Presently it would download on your desktop or laptop and install the game app. It may take quite some time, or perhaps it might possibly be amazingly quickly. It all is going to depend on our connection to the web. This has actually completed installing. Back to the emulator desktop by simply clicking on that option I'm emphasizing in green, so that you can start Street Fighter Duel for the first time. I am presently on the emulator desktop, and then we're on the way to simply click that brand new Street Fighter Duel icon which has been created. That video game is started for the very first time. So there we end up with it. I could press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to talk about the volume of that emulator. It's right here. We use the icon of higher volume as well as the icon of lower volume. This manner we won't count on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of this emulator. As well as to appreciate the experience to the max, we should activate the large monitor, for which we have two choices. That is simply the first one. We simply click on that software icon which I'm mentioning in green color. Then the display screen is maximized, getting one border on top, one on the right side and one at the bottom. In the case that we wish to run the app using all the screen, we click this particular game icon. So we would probably by now be experiencing and enjoying the game app in 100% screen function. To get out of the 100% screen mode, click the F11 key. And we might by now play in regular display screen setting. At this moment I am starting to demonstrate you the keys mapping, and that is definitely quite cool. That means we may be able to operate the game app much more effortlessly. The first thing is to mouse click this keyboard icon. And right now there you will be able to complete the appropriate setups. I most certainly will put the standard configuration, however if you want to improve that, you may very well achieve it with no problem. Obviously, the emulator is totally in our own language. In certain cases it occurs that your emulator is started in the incorrect language, for instance, in Chinese. So to set it up in the correct language we click here to the cogwheel. So right here within various other configuration settings, we mouse click on the language drop down. We should select the language we like, Italian, Chinese, and so on. After the language is selected, we are going to save, the emulator would reboot, and the Android game, the next time we use it, would of course be in the opted for language. Right now, there's another thing that we need to take into consideration, and this is that we will get a message from Google Mail indicating that a brand new device has been connected with our own Google account. It will definitely check with us if we are the people who have connected that electronic device. Yes, we ought not be troubled, considering the fact that emulator is simulating in Google Android electronic device. And then to discover which smartphone or tablet is currently being emulated, we visit right here, to the cogwheel and we click on it. And so we go here to the model selection. And there we observe that the emulator is simulating a Samsung cellular phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it folks, so much for my video tutorial. I hope that you enjoyed it, specifically that everyone found it handy. If so, bring it a nice like, subscribe to our channel, and I will be happy to answer your remarks, questions or ideas, put them in the comment area below. You could also leave comments on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams occasionally, you get it down below in the video description and in the initial pinned comment. Simply click on any of these video tutorials which are usually showing up on the suggestion of videos to watch, and let's have fun again in the next video tutorials. Bye.